Hello guys, welcome back. So if you see a circuit, if you open any manual and see the circuit, you'll find hardly any source, like few sources, few loads, but rest remaining, what is left is the switches only actually. So many switches will be there and you have to learn the symbols, the working part to understand how does the circuit is working. So let's begin and we'll start first with the biggest of the switch on board ship, and that is ACB, air circuit breaker. So where does it lie? Basically, a generator is producing power, giving it to the MSB, and in between lies a switch which we call as ACB, air circuit breaker. How do we operate this? How is it switched on and switched off? Well, this is operated by either automatically or manually. So we can just push a button on top of it. Like there are buttons here. Manually we can push the button on and off. However, it also happens automatically because there are inside there's a control arrangement given, which there are some coils that are closing coils, there are trip coils or undervoltage coils which are basically helping operate this switch here. So ACB is the switch. This is the ACB, right? So we will see that in detail later, but you already have some idea, I presume, about this, and this is how it is represented in a circuit. Well, these symbols may vary from maker to maker, but normally I'll try to show you the mostly common symbols that are used in the industry. Alright, so this is ACB, which is the biggest switch on board ship. Moving on, after ACB, the second biggest switches on board ship is MCCB, molded case circuit breakers, which in common language on board ship we'll simply call them as breakers. Okay, so if you have to call someone, please help me with close the breaker, or MCCB, they'll simply say, please go ahead and close the breaker, just like that. Alright, so how this is operated, again, this is how it looks, and you know that it is manually operated, meaning you have to switch on manually and switch off manually. However, the tripping action can be automatic. Tripping in the case of overcurrent or short circuit condition, or remote tripping for some other purposes can be achieved. So that can be automatic. However, switching on is mostly it is manual. Alright, so this is how it is represented. So before I go ahead, we also talk about the voltages in these two. ACB is, of course, power coming from generator. It has to be three phase, could be 440 volts or even higher, 3.3 or 6.6 kV. But in those cases, we don't use air circuit breaker. We use vacuum circuit breaker or SF6 breaker. Anyway, so this is what we studied in high voltage systems. Let's leave it for now. MCCB is again three phase for 40 volt system. This is how it is represented on the circuit. It could be some other symbol as well. Please remember the number 52. Wherever you see number 52, it is MCCB. Okay, so this is how it looks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, many of those. So this is how they look. Now they isolate the power. They are basically used for isolation purposes. If you want to isolate certain section of the power, I'll operate this one. Okay, now 52, this is how it is represented on in a circuit. So 52, please remember these three numbers, which will be handy for you later on. 52 is for circuit breaker, MCCB. 88 is for contactor. 51 is for OCR, overcurrent relay. And these numbers are universal. If you find 88 or 51, they'll be representing the same thing every diagram what you study. So after this, let's go further. Okay, so Now after MCCB, we comes to MCB. Now what's the difference between ACB, MCB and MCCB and MCB is the size as well as power difference, power they transmit, voltage and current they transmit. Maximum for ACB, medium for MCCB, lower for MCB. So it can transmit power but not as great as MCCB and ACB. Anyway, operation is similar to MCCB. There's hardly any difference. Manually open close and auto trip. If you talk about the phases, MCCB generally is three phase. MCB could be single phase, three phase, like that. As you can see here, this is a single pole MCB, this is a two pole MCB, it's a four pole MCB. So they can be able to trip four different lines at one go. This can trip two different lines at one go. One could be live or neutral, live or neutral. This could be just live, like that. Or it could be also transporting, means switching the three phase system. So there's no fixed rule for MCB. So this is what normally you see in the single phase system. In your homes also. On ship also, any control system circuit or accommodation power circuit or any single phase system definitely will have isolation through MCB. Like in your home is a single phase, you are having MCB there. How do we represent them on the circuit? Well, I know this is only two cables, so two cable means single phase. So I can't use, so I'll really be using MCCB. So normally MCB will be used here. This is MCB, this is MCB, this is MCB, like that. Ratings given on top of it. All right, okay. So next in the line is contactor. As I told you, remember the number 88? It's normally used for contactor. So this is a switch part of contactor. Now you may ask, hey, this is also 88. Is it also conductor? Yes. But since this is circle, it's a load part. And this is what the switch is. They both are in the same conductor. But since we are studying switches, so this is of relevance to us. 88 conductor switch. Conductor, it's operate. Who is operating this? It is not hand operated, gentlemen. Unlike MCCB, sorry for that. Unlike MCCB, MCB contactor is not manually operated. So this is how the contactor look like. So you can say that a switch which is automatically operated and can carry three phase power signal or power, not signal, which can carry three phase power, and but can be remotely automatically operated. Do we have any switch like that? Yes. And what is the name? Contactor. So it's a switch just like MCCB. It's a three-phase switch, but the difference is MCCB is manually open-closed. This is automatically open-closed. Okay, all right. So basically, conductor will be used when you want automatic operation, remote operations. You don't want to physically go somewhere and operate the system. Then comes the next part is the relay. So relay is again similar to conductor. It's a coil-operated thing. So there's no difference at all in the working principle. It's also called a coil operated like conductor. You will find a coil just like conductor has a coil. This relay will also, or relay switch will also have its own coil. So you can see number 4 is a relay coil and this number 4 is the relay switch. So switches will look like this or like this. Alright, how does it look like? This is how it looks like. Generally smaller in size than contactors. And this is how they look like. Alright, so we will be studying the contactors and relays and their working in details later on. That's all for now. We'll continue this, the switches in the next module. If you liked the video and you want to go for electrical circuit package, then please go to the description below and click the link.